Right now, the most important type of system that will go across control systems for any subject in general is linear and nonlinear systems. So, a linear system is the one which obeys the principle of superposition and principle of homogeneity, and a nonlinear is the one which doesn't obey both of them. Okay, so what is this homogeneity and superposition first of all? So homogeneity is said to be obeyed by a system if it produces an output y of t for an input x of t, then it must produce an output a into y of t for an input a into x of t. That means a scalar multiplied with the input signal should give the same scalar multiplied with the output. In the total output, right? Then you can say that the system is obeying homogeneity principle. Then when you can say the system is obeying superposition principle, so you can say that if a system which produces an output y1 of t for an input x1 of t and also an output y2 of t for an input x2 of t, then if it produces an output y1 of t plus y2 of t for an input x1 of t plus x2 of t, then we can say that it is obeying superposition principle. Right. So how we can combine these two principles, we are going to see now. If we combine both homogeneity and superposition, we can say that in case of continuous time, if a system is producing an output like this, that is, suppose if the input is a into x1 of t plus b into x2 of t, it should produce an output which is equals to a into y1 of t plus b into y2 of t. There the transformation of, where the capital T indicates transformation, right? If the transformation is like this, that means transformation of x1 of t is nothing but y1 of t. Transformation of x2 of t is nothing but y2 of t. If the transformation of a into x1 of t plus b into x2 of t is producing a into transformation of x1 of t plus b into transformation of x2 of t, you can say that it is obeying both homogeneity and superposition. That means it is a linear transformation. That means the system is linear. Then only you can transform in a linear fashion. Right, similarly for discrete time also it will apply the same thing. You just replace small t with small n. Okay, right. Thank you.